around this way. You want me to go first on this one?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, should we do our duty? Okay, our job is done. Really cut it up to quarter ways. The hell. There we go. Boy, I tell you what, the other day I was gonna buy trade the 690 here. I was gonna trade it in for a 500 EXCF. Gosh, I don't know if that's the right way. Hey, Bill, I don't know if that's the right way. What's it looking like?
Totally sucks. It's vertical. I'm stopped.
All right, well, see if you can turn around and come back down. I don't think this is a sanction.
Copy.
Totally a vertical and it sucks, so turn around and come back. I don't think this is a sanctioned trail. This is the way we want to keep going. But anyway, getting back to the old 690 here. I actually went to a dealership on Friday, walked in, said, all right. And I brought this with me. I said, let's go, 500 EXCF. They didn't have one. So now I'm wondering if that wasn't a good thing, because dang, this thing is so capable. It's heavy, don't get me wrong. But because I ride ATV tracks most of the time, I don't know, it just doesn't make sense. Because the 500 EXCF, if I want the power out of it, it's going to cost an extra $1,000 for a new ECU and whatever else you got to do for it. So now you're up around $13,000, $14,000. And hell, for that, might as well buy the...
I think it's going to take me a while. I'm going to have to pull it down backwards. I'm in a big groove.
All right, you want me to come up and help?
All right, give me about 5 minutes.
Copy. Anyway, so for the price it would be to get the 500 EXCF and ECU and all that kind of stuff, I might as well just buy the 890. So, I don't know. I am indecisive as far as which way I want to go with my motorcycles. So, I guess until I can definitively say for more than just a single day that yes, this is the bike I want, I guess I'll just keep what I got. All right, kill it. I'll take it. So one nice thing about this being so small for me, because I can put the weight on the back tire.
And it'll catch.
Except for it slipped. Oh, come on. Well, I would say let's take a break, but we're almost there.
Let's do it.
So it's a couple hundred yards.
We still have 8 lives left.
Okay. damn it. That's a hard hit. Pretty sloppy in here. Oh gosh. It's a nice rink. See what I mean by that slick stuff?
Yeah. You see my back end going all over the place?
No.
Like, I just had both feet down. I was doing the ski thing.
Yeah, no, no.
Like, oh,
you,
my gosh.
You got away from me, and at that point, I was struggling, so.
Oh, I'm sorry.
No, it's all right.
And there's no way I can see behind me. I don't know how you do. Oh, because you don't have goggles.
I'll
turn and try to look behind me. Can't see nothing.
No worries. We got the radios.
All right.
So if you're ever in trouble, remember that little music symbol there. That's an intention getter.
Which top left?
Bottom.
I can't actually read those
right
buttons.
There.
Okay. All right. Okay.
That's the I need to talk to you immediately
talk
button.
To you.
All right.
Okay.
Ooh, nice save. That was a good save.
Wow.
Oh, there's more.
I didn't dump it. I hate that mud.
I told you.
Yeah, it sucks.
So we'll keep going. Get a little fast section and clear out. Clear out your tires. All right. So, if there's any one reason that I need a 500, it's to simply be able to make these tight turns, because this is all the turning radius I get, and it's just not sharp enough. I'm coming, I'll be there in a sec. Oh, this mud is so horrible. Terrible slick. Shit, did you see that? Wow. Dang it. Son of a gun. Oh. Good Lord. I hit that neutral.
Welcome to the land of Bill. Oh. That was an effort. Oh, surprised I didn't hit the skid plate on that one. That was quite the drop. Control your speed. Ooh, see, here's another big one. One of these days, I'm gonna remember to have it in the correct gear.
Jeez. I'm last. Okay, so with that slight washout there that you just witnessed, let's talk about the D606 tires. More importantly, just the front, because the back is awesome no matter what. But it is often said that you go with the 606 on the back and the Pirelli MT21 on the front, because the front grips better than the 606 does. Oh, and again. So now you've witnessed it twice. For me, that's about time number 6 or 7 that I've noticed the 606 front tire washing out, where the MT21 never did. So So, needless to say, I won't use the 606 on the front anymore. I did this time just because it was in stock and I didn't have to wait. And I said, well, how much of a difference could it make? Well, now I can say with certainty it makes a big difference. So, if you're looking for like a 90-10 tire to put on your dual sport, go with the D606 on the back and the Pirelli MT21 on the front. Well, you and I both did almost the same thing.
Yeah, that was fun.
Which way? I think it's this way.
I meant to stop here because of this intersection, you see.
That's perfect. Well, you know what? Let's take a break. We'll